External appearances of your houses or compounds in Uganda is not a thing that a lot of people pay attention to, but I'm here to give you information, my friend. Designs and finishes do not only happen indoors. Start paying attention to how you design your outdoors. And today I'm excited to tell you that we are bringing you pristine pavers, yeah, to give you an understanding of what exactly you need to look for when buying pavers. We are still at the Kololo Independence Ground, and I'm excited to bring to you a gentleman who is changing the game of pavement. Mukuru,
yes, sir.
What is this, plastic?
No, this is concrete. This pure is concrete, 100%, all the way from the bottom to the top.
Just to give you information, for your own information, if you don't have a dumbbell at home, and you want to put, where I call a mukono, this is multi-purpose. This is so heavy. You know, I've tried to move around and hold, you know, carry some pavements around, but this weight is extraordinary. Oh, funinamuwa. That's a conversation we're going to have, yeah? So introduce yourself. My name is Francis Mukle. I'm from Urban TV, and this is the Homes and Construction Show. You're welcome. What's your name, sir?
You're welcome, Francis. My name is Andrew Atwine. I'm one of the directors at Sterling Pavers Hub. Our aim is to do quality products. It's not about the weight. It's about the quality. I want a customer to be happy. Make your compound, make your home, be happy in it for the next 10, 15, 20 years, and still remains pristine.
So what makes your pavements actually different? Because I almost thought this was plastic from first impression.
Yes, it's what we had. So this particular you're holding is garden tile. This is where you don't want people to step on your grass. They can walk, and that is the thickness. So it's heavy enough to handle the personal weight. You can ride a bike on it, but not for driving. So this is a garden tile where you walk. These designs are meant to prevent slip. They are unslip surfaces, which is common with all our pavers, all our garden tiles, that you cannot slide. Because it rains, it's outdoor, you can slide and have an accident. So the designs are meant to prevent the slippery.
So certainly what I take off from this is that not every paver will work anywhere. It has to be specifically designed for a particular space, right?
Yes, so this particular one is for the walkways. Then we have those for the driveways. And our pavers are made in a way that we don't know what kind of car is going to ride on. Any car will handle, be the small car, the heavy car, but with the mind of a heavy car. So our pavers are heavy duty. The beauty should not deceive you. The smoothness, you may think it's something mild. No, it's actually heavy, it's durable, it's standard.
All right, so let me put this down, and then we go deep into these pavements. What I take off is that one is called a bubble tile, right?
Yeah, that's a bubble tile.
Okay, so just come in here.
We have three designs.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. We have the bubble tile, the one you're holding. We have the Sigma.
Okay.
So it's about the taste of the customer. This you call it the Sigma tile. The customer chooses what they like. And then we have the checkered.
So that's still for the garden, right?
That's still for the garden.
Okay.
We also have the checkered tile. It's also for the garden. So the customer is free to choose depending on how you feel. They give you different feeling, impression when you step on them with the bare feet. And we know in gardens we want to walk barefooted, want to get in touch with nature. So this enhances the feeling that you get as you walk on them.
What about these ones?
Now, these are pavers. So this particular one, it's called a star. It's called a star paver.
Mm-hmm.
And as you can tell, it's thick. This is a 60 millimeter thick concrete paver. It can carry any weight of a motor vehicle, and to still remain intact as it's meant to be. Like I said, the smoothness on the surface should not deceive you. The pattern on the top is for anti-slip, so that you can walk barefooted, you can drive on it, and you won't skid. But it's also smooth enough to have a good feel on your feet as you walk. So it is, this, it's clean, it is smooth, it's beautiful, but it's also heavy and reliable. So it's beauty with quality all in one combination.
Amazing. And then this one?
So when you have an ending to your paving, you're moving to the gardens where you have a green, we have curbstones. And these are two kinds. Now the angular curbstone is to enable where you free and people...
Angular.
Yes, it's angular because of the edges. You can drive from the paving onto the grass.
Okay.
So you may... Let's say you have many visitors, yes. It's an end point for the paving to the grass. It's a transition point.
Okay.
So beauty is transferred from the paver to the grass.
Okay.
Now, at one point, you're free people driving onto your lane. It's okay. You give them this one. If you don't want people to drive onto your lane, then we advise this. If you can touch, you'll feel it's smooth.
Mm.
So it's not easy. Yes, you can't drive on this one. So where you say, this is the drive area, every car, every drive stops here. You don't go beyond.
If you step when you slide.
You can't drive on top over this. But if you're free with driving on top, then you take this one. So the beauty, it also matches along with the purpose you intend to have in your garden. So this one type of the paver. The other type we have is what we call the double T. The double T, again, it's 60 millimeter thickness. The pattern and design on top is to prevent slippery, but it's also concrete from top to bottom. The smooth, the slick feel shouldn't deceive you about its purpose. The strength, it's intentional. We make this in any color you want. You choose. This may look like white, but this is cement. So you may come in, I want blue, I want brown, I want blue, I want black, I want red. You're the king. You decide.
You know, the pearl finishing is something that really amazes me, you know.
Because beauty, you see, these are homes you sleep in. And what's used to come to a home you don't like, you're never comfortable with. Have beauty in a home, feel at home, love your environment, love your compound, step out of the house, love the outside.
I've always told people, after the Haswan Basso of Kampala, your home, yeah, should act like a resting.
This is, we call it a half moon. You notice the pattern is similar to the full moon, we'll be going to it. Again, the same thickness, the same slick feel, the same anti, yes, for driving on, and it's about the pattern that you'd like to have. Mm-hmm. Yes.
I could tell you, you know what, I want this kind of pattern, and you still go with that.
Yes, so you tell us, do you like the half moon, do you like the double T that we've just looked at, do you like the full moon, which is the biggest? Apparently, most of our customers go for the full moon because of its oval shape, and it gives you the floral pattern as you design your compound. And we've had this in quite many colors. Again, it's bulky. You can have a feel. Six kilograms.
Oh, man.
Wow. This is so heavy. Okay.
You drive on it, it remains intact. Even if it's a trailer, you drive on, it remains smooth, remains beautiful, remains intact. So this one, we call it a full moon.
So I get the impression that, you know, for several, like, industrial parks, yeah? Where, you know, it's common for trucks to move. This is the deal, right?
Yes, this is the deal. And then we have the double T, the rectal rock. This is the most common. And for places that have heavy traffic, we advise this one because it looks quite perfectly where cars are turning. Maybe you have a park, like the taxi park, the industrial park, where cars are many. We advise this one because it looks quite fine and for the tires to turn in between them. This might become a deterrent, but this comes fine where you have heavy traffic most of the time. But again, it's also 60 millimeter thickness, full concrete, but with an anti-slip surface and a smooth finish. Yes. Then we have a grass paver.
Okay. Talk to me about the grass paver. This the one?
Yes, it's a grass paver. So the grass paver, you have a compound. It's close to either a swamp or you have, whenever it rains, water stagnates. It takes a while to seep to the surface. But you have an area where you walk through. So you put a grass paver. You plant grass in the pockets.
Okay.
So you can walk on this. It's a firm surface, and the water that has stuck on the top seeps through gradually, and you have a neat compound. So you maintain your green, but a firm surface to walk on and do whatever you want to do.
No.
So that's what prevents. Yes. And then, of course, we have the blocks for those who are constructing. 6-inch, 8-inch, the ones that are usually used for construction.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now the question of the day, installation.
Installation. We have people we partner with, quite a number of them. What we do is, as Sterling Pavers, we pride ourselves in the quality of the product. We want to do the product that the best way we can deliver to you. But we have partnerships to do the transportation. We have partnerships to do the laying, and we'll advise and recommend them. They understand that the customer is important to us. They understand the value of quality to us, not just from the product, but even the laying. But if you have your own person, still it's okay.
All right. So, right now in real estate, the biggest challenge is substandard products, and also, and a lot, the trend is that many people build without having the right information, and then after they've gotten the right information, they will break to fix the problem. Now I want you to tell the viewer out there, how can they, what do they have to look at while buying these products, these pavers, so that they don't end up making mistakes of, oh, I bought those pavers, now they're breaking. I bought these pavers, my kids are sliding off. I bought these pavers, and yeah, those kinds of things.
Quite many people do construction. They're not aware that there are standards that each of these products has got to meet. So, for example, the minimum standards I would recommend for any paver is on a crash test is MPA 30.
What's that?
It's a crash test. So the Ministry of Works has laboratories in Chira. You take any of these products and they'll test and they tell you whether it meets the quality or not. Now, as a standard to us as Sterling Pavers, every quarter we do a test of our products. And the minimum...
After 3 months?
Quarter. Yes, in three months, we test our products to ensure that the quality is maintained. And the quality comes from the materials that we use, the way they are mixed, and the process of production to ensure that the thickness, the strength remains intact across board. So what I'd advise that, number one, go to anyone who's producing. Pick a sample, your own sample. Enter the yard and pick any piece you'd want. Okay. Then go and test it. It should be meeting there.
But before you buy?
Before you buy, yes.
Unless I come to you, yes. Get the product, yes. Take it to those guys.
The laboratory, they'll test it for you and they'll tell you whether it meets the standards or not.
Is it not costly?
There is a cost, yes. But this is a government laboratory. Again, what's cheaper? To test the product before you use it or to break the house and reconstruct it? So ultimately, it's much, much cheaper to test. But us as Sterling Pavers, we take it upon ourselves to test our products, make sure that they meet the quality standards. Even the blocks, we test them. So any paver you see here, or even those that we have in the yard, I give you assurance, money back guarantee, they'll be above 30 MPa on a crash test.
It's amazing. You see, it's my first time seeing this kind of pavers, honestly speaking. And I'm wondering, what has been your process of preparing to launch into the market, you know, to give people these high quality products? Because now, I imagine you saw a loophole that you're trying to fix. Now, talk to me about the loophole and how long it took you to get to this stage.
So the loophole is quite many. Number one, which was most important to us, is how beautiful is the home supposed to be? We build structures, you do beautiful painting. Then gardens, you can easily have them because you have green. Uganda is green. But then where you come to pave, you want a bit of color in it. You want a design in it. And that's where we came in. That was number one. Number two, there are different modes through which you can make pavers. There are various ways. Rubber, plastic, stone dust. But then we preferred the concrete because you're not going to be replacing pavers today, tomorrow, after a year. You want to lay your pavers and for the next 20 years, they are as good as if they were placed yesterday. That's number one. Number two, quite often when you lay the subsurface structure makings, let's say pipes, trenches, you need to do repairs. So without pavers, you can remove these pavers, do the repairs, you'll put back the pavers and they'll still be intact because they won't break. As a result, because the materials we use, which is concrete, it's firm enough that you remove them, do the repairs, you'll put the pavers back and they'll be intact.
What I take out from what kind of loophole you're covering is, first of all, is sustainability, longevity, and beauty. And that's what you're changing on the market. Now, does the shape, size, weight determine the price?
No. Price is per square meter. We charge 45,000 per square meter. The design, the shape is up to us as a customer. Because it's square meter, whether it's the full moon or it's a rectal rock, it's a star, it's still a square meter. But you have preferences as an individual. We even have some who say, I want this particular design. We'll talk, we'll get a mold in and make the design that you want. Ultimately, the important part is that what the paver looks like, the pattern develops, is the customer's satisfaction. The color it has is the customer's satisfaction. Our interest is that whichever product we give you, it must be top quality. So our emphasis on the quality, the design and the color, that's for the customer to choose. Yeah.
So the customer has the liberty to choose the color, design, but now you have to do the quality and then the beautification and ensuring that this thing stands the test of time and value for money is eventually achieved. Now tell me, why should I choose these pavers over just having a cement floor or stones on my floor?
The cement, because when you're laying cement, it's a thin layer.
Yeah.
In 5-10 years, it will wear out.
Going to break.
Again, cement is for walking on. It's not for driving on. you're going to have a heavy vehicle. Maybe you're bringing in furniture or you're moving out anything, and then it breaks. So you need something that will last a test of time. Two, we have an option for color, which adds beauty. You may not be able to do the coloring the way you do with cement. So we offer that in our products.
Yeah, coloring actually is an interesting piece.
Yes, we've had interesting colors, blue, green. We've had orders in those colors. You may find it out, but that's what the customer wants. Blue is their blue. It's when they feel at home, and that's what we give them. Yes.
Blue is a rare color for pavement. All right, so it's very interesting. You know, this particular event here, the Expo, was organized under the theme, you know, standards, innovation, and trends, and various opportunities. And I'm really very excited by the fact that I believe whoever has come to this Expo is now trying to understand that there's actually quite a product on the market. And I hope that with this conversation, people out there will understand what it means for one to buy a quality pavement. Is there anything else you want to add?
Yes, my learning point, actually, which I hadn't thought about, is that we've had customers come here, and in our discussions, they think this paver will be the best for their basketball courts. We hadn't thought about that way.
Yeah. Yeah. Yes.
And especially the Rector Rock and the Star.
For me, it's this one.
Now,
the way the ball bounces off of it, you know, I've tried to play some bit of basketball. Mm-hmm. So, you know, there's a vibe that this flooring and finishing gives you when you get the ball and bounce off it.
So the ones you've had, their choice was on the Rector Rock and then the Star to be the decent surfaces. And so going on from here, it's our take home to engage them further and discuss on how best we can help them get the surface that they would want. It looks quite fine, cleans very easily, and is smooth, has the anti-grip. So no worries that if you're making a dash for a dunk, your feet, you're on the farm ground.
Talk to me about maintenance.
Maintenance, all you need is water and a brush.
So these days, some people construct in places that are wetlands. Yeah? Mm-hmm. So
for the wetlands, that's why we recommend this one. Because it allows the water to seep to the surface. It's quite a one hand cannot do.
This is for the wetland. Yeah, so for the wetland, this is it, yeah? Yeah, if you have a wet compound or anything. All right. I also have another question about, should I have a plan, a preset mindset of, you know, I'm building my house and this is where I want my pavements to be, or it's just something that I wake up in the morning and realize, oh, I think this place could do with pavements also?
Yes, actually quite often most of us look at the structure plans for the house, and then when you are done, you okay, let me pave. But our advice is get guidance, get plans on the gardening so that everything is compressed. So we have partners we work with that do landscaping, that do the gardening, that will give you the pastures you need, will give you the flowers you need. And at that point, that's your time when you do the planning, where you designate, this is a driveway, this is the parking area, this has to go to be green, I want plants this side, I want fruits this side, I want this kind of flowers. And usually the best time to do this is when you're completing your structure. You're done with the vehicles moving in, bringing the sand materials, you're done with that, you're done with the plastering, and now you're looking at the outside. At that point, it's important to plan for the garden, for the area you want. And it gives you the opportunity to also have theme colors with the house. So if the house is, your theme is maroon, your theme is brown, then you can say, I want the pavers to reflect the theme of the house. And at that point is where we come in and say, yes, we agree with you, these colors go with your house. If it's a green theme, you may need green. If it's a brown theme, then you do the brown paver so that you maintain the theme and the entire home becomes a light, because you feel from the point where you're looking at the surface or you're looking at the walls, you're looking at the perimeter wall, everything is themed up. You're looking at the flowers, everything is beautiful. Yes.
Amazing. So, installation again. Let's go back to installation.
Yes.
So, what questions do I need to ask? Imagine I'm hiring you to do my pavement, yes? What question do I need to ask you, or what should I look out for to ensure that I'm hiring the right person?
I think it comes to how well the other person understands the laying. You see, laying pavers, these are precast. You just place them. But before the placement, Do you understand the surface? Number one, is it leveled? Number two, what kinds of soils do you have? So if you have got thin soils or weak soils, you may need to apply marram and then compress to have an even surface, then do the sanding and then do the paving. But when you ask a person as it tells you, just come and place the pavers, there's a problem with this guy. And it's also better to ask two or three people so that you compare the notes. Usually, you may not be subject matter on a particular aspect, but if I talk to number one, number two, number three, and I compare the notes, I'll be able to tell who's out of the lane. Or you can come to us and we'll consult and we'll give you the processes on how to lay the pavers. Or if you're torn between, you can ask us to engage the person who's going to lay for you and give guidance on whether he actually meets the purpose. And then three, usually, is that you need to be present when people are working.
You have to be there. Physical presence is key.
Not necessarily you have to be there full day, but you need to see what they are doing so that what they promise you is what they deliver. It's important. Sometimes just give materials to a person, go and make for me a compound. When you come and find pavers laid, you may not know what's actually below. But if you have a constant check on them to ensure that what they're giving you is actually a quality product.
Generally speaking, I'm a young person and I'm aspiring to own a house and get into real estate and build my own houses. Generally speaking, what are the key points I should look out for? These are parting shots.
The key things you should look out for, one, is where you're going to construct, preferably not in a wetland. If you pick a wetland, it will be really costly. But if you have the money, that's okay. That's a different story. Because the amount of investment you put in the surface before you come up, it's quite heavy. And then two, find reliable suppliers for your products. Be it the sand, be it the cement. Then three, find people that are credible to do the construction. The surface, the terrain may be okay, materials are okay, but if you have poor workmanship, then you have a poor product at the end. So for me, those are the key things I look out for whenever you're doing construction.
All right. It was a pleasure doing business with you. Alright guys, what I take out from this conversation is information is key, number one. Number two, when you intend to do anything, do with pavements, please know what purpose that space is going to serve. Number three, find the right people to do the job for you. I'm just only doing my part to inform you because you don't want to break and build again. My name is Francis Emukule and I hope this particular session has been very helpful for you in your real estate journey. Catch us next time, same place, same time here on Urban TV on the Homes and Construction Show. See you then.